Western diamondback rattlesnakes are animals that are mostly found in the Americas and may frighten even the bravest of people. Along with venomous spiders, scorpions, and a number of venomous lizard species, the majority of which have the ability to cause significant, and in some cases, even fatal injury to humans. They are among the most well-known reptiles in the American Southwest. The region additionally hosts a variety of large predators, including mountain lions, black bears, and coyotes, all of which, of course, can also pose a danger to humans under the right circumstances. The risks associated with the wildlife in this region were demonstrated in 2018 when Jeremy Sutcliffe, a resident of Corpus Christi, Texas, was helping his wife with some yard work when he'd stumbled upon a 4-foot-long rattlesnake, an encounter that would change the course of his life forever. According to the World Health Organization, an estimated 5.4 million snake bites occur worldwide each year, with up to 2.7 million resulting in envenomation. Of these cases, approximately 138 result in death and around 400 in permanent disability. And comparatively, while the 70 to 80 annually reported snake bites in the US may seem like a high number, it most certainly, of course, pales in comparison to the global statistics, but not to mention highlights the need for greater attention to be paid to snakebite management and prevention, especially in more affected regions. On what started out as a peaceful day on May 14th of 2018, the young and happily married Texas couple Jeremy and Jennifer Sutcliffe were doing some yard work ahead of a family barbecue set for later that afternoon. However, their peaceful day was just minutes into it, disrupted, when Jennifer would stumble upon a large western diamondback rattlesnake in the couple's garden. And this rattler measured over a meter in length. Jennifer instantly began screaming for aid as the snake quickly assumed a striking stance and rattled its tail in aggression. In the meantime, her husband Jeremy, who was accustomed to handling non-venomous rat snakes, rushes to her rescue with a shovel in the hopes that he can just scoop it out of harm's way. Jennifer is unable to move because she is wedged between a house wall and a clump of plants, and the rattlesnake is once more close enough to her to strike. She knows that if she makes a mistake, it might have fatal implications. When Jeremy eventually comes on the scene and approaches the snake with his shovel, which feels like an eternity later, he tries to scoop it up. He would, however, quickly realize that its large size made this task much easier said than done. After several failed attempts, a frustrated Jeremy would then resort to a much more drastic measure and swings the edge of the shovel down with force, decapitating the snake. Relieved that the snake was neutralized, a shaken-up Jennifer, after witnessing this, goes inside to calm down, while Jeremy sorted out how he was going to dispose of the body. Concerned that their dogs might mess with it, Jeremy then impulsively decides to remove the over a meter long rattler by hand, unaware of the still very present dangers of doing so. Just as he bent down to pick up the head of the snake is when the unthinkable would happen. As the snake instinctually jumped in the air, managing to sink its fangs into his hand, and faster than the blink of an eye, it would rapidly inject what was likely its entire venom sac into his fingers. It's important to note that even after decapitation, a rattlesnake's head can still continue to function due to a reflex mechanism controlled by the brainstem. This reflex can be triggered by any perceived threat or stimulation, making it a significant danger to humans who mistakenly believe that a decapitated snake can pose one no harm. Jennifer, in a panic, knowing the situation was serious, immediately dialed 911. As she rushed her husband to the local hospital by car. It is during this time that Jeremy begins seizing and passing out, as the swollen and blistered bite side continued to worsen by the minute. It was at about a quarter way to the hospital that Jeremy barely manages to communicate through severely slurred speech that he can no longer see. Jennifer was forced to pull over and ask the 911 operator that she was on the phone with to promptly send an ambulance to their location. Fortunately, the medics arrived within just minutes, and Jeremy is then airlifted to a hospital by a helicopter, where his life would hang in the balance. The venom of rattlesnakes can cause varying effects on the human body, with the western diamondback being particularly potent due to its mixture of enzymes and toxins, which include myotoxins, hemotoxins, as well as neurotoxins. These toxins have the potential to seriously harm the body, including internal bleeding, harm to the neurological system, and injury to muscles and tissue around the bite location. Weakness, numbness, tingling, and a rapid heartbeat are some of the immediate symptoms, and severe cases can result in paralysis, respiratory failure, and even death. After a brief examination, doctors informed Jennifer that Jeremy was in critical condition and that there was a chance that this bite could prove fatal. And this was despite him having received a significant amount of a powerful antivenom known as crofovir. For Western diamondback rattlesnake bites, antivenom can help neutralize the venom and reduce the severity of symptoms, improving the chances of recovery. A few hours later, Jeremy's kidneys would begin to give in to the shock of the venom, requiring immediate dialysis and various antibiotics to keep him alive. He was then dosed with 26 doses of the expensive antidote to help combat the superdose of venom that he'd received. Shortly after the incident took place, his story would go viral, leaving many in disbelief at the idea of a beheaded snake still being able to bite. Meanwhile, Jeremy continued to fight, unable to stand and requiring significant medical attention. The cost of the antivenom and medical expenses already tallying about $60. The Sutcliffes would resort to starting a GoFundMe campaign in order to help cover the expenses, highlighting even more the unfortunate reality of healthcare costs in the US. Jennifer then gets word from the doctors that two of Jeremy's fingers are so badly damaged that amputation was necessary. Jeremy, despite this news, would remain optimistic upon hearing it and considered this a small sacrifice compared to what was potentially a fatal outcome, and so would continue to battle through a grueling recovery process with everything that he had in him. It wasn't until after about a month that Jeremy's determination would finally pay off as his kidneys would begin to function again, providing the doctors and his family with hope for his recovery. And a couple of weeks later, by late June, he would be released from the hospital and returned to their dream home in Progress, which is when the Sutcliffes were finally able to enjoy their aforementioned long-awaited family barbecue. According to experts, taking precautions is crucial to avoiding snake bites. In fact, a study published in the Wilderness and Environmental Medicine Journal found that wearing long pants and boots reduced the risk of snake bites by up to 85%. Additionally, the use of a flashlight at night can also significantly reduce the risk of stepping on a snake, avoiding areas where snakes may be hiding, such as tall grass or piles of leaves, is also important. As David Seberg, president of the America College of Emergency Physicians, explained, rattlesnakes like to hide in places like rock piles, wood piles, and tall grass. But you must be careful when you're walking around in these areas. You have to keep your eyes peeled for snakes and make sure you give them plenty of space if you do see one. Even today, Jeremy's near-fatal encounter serves as a sobering reminder of the significance of leaving dead snakes alone and making sure to contact a professional to remove them from your property. Snakes play a crucial role in the ecology because they control rodent populations. By being cautious and paying attention to your surroundings, you may reduce your risk of getting bitten by a snake, take in the beauty and wonders of nature, and protect both yourself and these critically endangered creatures.